Today we're going to talk about fractions. We will use tangrams to make, combine, and compare fractions. Let's start with a square and a small triangle. The square can be covered with two small triangles. So the square is equal to two small triangles. There is only one small triangle in a small triangle, so we can make the fraction 1 over 2 or 1 half. The small triangle is 1 half the square. Let's now look at the medium triangle and the small triangle. The medium triangle can be covered with two small triangles, so the medium triangle is equal to two small triangles, so the small triangle is half the medium triangle. Now let's look at the parallelogram. Just like the square and the medium triangle, the parallelogram can be covered with two small triangles, so the parallelogram is equal to two small triangles, and the small triangle is half the parallelogram. The small triangle is half of the square, half of the medium triangle, and half of the parallelogram. Let's look at the large triangle and a small triangle. The large triangle can be covered with four small triangles. Remember, when you cover the large triangle, make sure there's no overlap, so the large triangle is equal to four small triangles. The small triangle is therefore 1/4 the large triangle. Let's make a square with the two large triangles. How many small triangles make up this big square? Let's count them. There are eight small triangles in the square made from the two large triangles. So the small triangle is 1/8 the bigger square. How many squares make up the big square? Let's count them. There are four squares in the square made from the two large triangles. So the square is 1/4 the bigger square. So the small triangle is 1/8 the bigger square, and the square is 1/4 the bigger square. Let's make a big rectangle using all seven shapes. Let's start with the square and see what fractional part it is of the rectangle. How many squares cover the rectangle? Let's count. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. There are 8 squares in this rectangle, so the square is 1/8 the rectangle. Now let's look at the large triangle. How many large triangles cover the rectangle? Again, let's count. 1, 2, 3, 4. There are 4 large triangles in this rectangle, so the large triangle is 1/4 the rectangle. Now, let's look at the small triangle. How many small triangles cover the rectangle? Again, let's count. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16. There are 16 small triangles in this rectangle, so the small triangle is 1/16 the rectangle. Now let's look at two shapes combined, the small triangle and the square. Together these are 1/16 plus 1/8 of the rectangle. How do we add these two fractions? Well, let's see how many small triangles go into the combined small triangle and square. That's easy. We've already done that. There are 1 in the small triangle and 2 in the square. So there are 3 small triangles in the combined figure. We also know that there are 16 small triangles in the rectangle. Using this, we can see that the combined shape is 3/16 of the rectangle. So 1/16 plus 1/8 equals 3/16. Let's look at another combined shape using the small triangle, medium triangle, and square. Together, these are 1/16 plus 1/8 plus 1/8 of the rectangle. Again, we know the combined shape can be covered by 5 small triangles. Also, we know that there are 16 small triangles in the rectangle, so the combined shape is 5/16 of the rectangle. So 1/16 plus 1/8 plus 1/8 equals 5/16. How about comparing fractions? Which is bigger, 1/4 or 1/8? Well, we know the larger triangle is 1/4 of the rectangle. Also, we know that the medium triangle is 1/8 of the rectangle. it's obvious the larger triangle is bigger than the medium triangle. So 1/4 is bigger than 1/8. There's our introduction to fractions using tangrams. Now it's time to practice and master fractions with tangrams.